गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन एंड थैंक यू मिस्टर हरी फ्रॉम आइस एक्सपो फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी टू दिस वेबिनार टुडे ऑन दिस संडे आफ्टरनून एंड आई वेलकम ऑल द स्पीकर्स ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड ऑल प्रोफेशनल्स फ्रॉम मेडिकल डिवाइस इंडस्ट्री टू दिस वेबिनार. माय ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन मिस्टर हरी हैज ऑलरेडी गिवन. I am the controlling and licensing authority of drugs control department, government of Delhi. And also from academically, I am the executive council member of Pharmacy Council of India. I will be speaking much about, you know, medical devices regulations, which came into the enforcement in our country. And everybody knows that MDR 2017, which were framed by Government of India, were implemented from 1st of January 2018 all over the country. During this COVID time, I can say this is the right way to interact, to exchange our knowledge, and also to update our all relevant issues, particularly in the field of health and medical devices. As per the MDR, I will not go in detail. All these medical devices were categorized into four categories: class A, class B, class C, and class D. That is critical and non-critical medical devices. And class A and class B medical devices are being regulated by state drug control departments. However, the class C and class D medical devices are regulated by central drug control department. Like formulations, whether it's a tablet or a capsule or any parenteral or any other dosage form, I can say the medical devices play a very important role in the healthcare system, particularly in treating the patient, in curing the patients by using certain devices and related products. That's why earlier there were some categories of, you know, items like IV sets, cannulas, they were categorized under the definition of drug. But long back in 2005, October 2005, Government of India brought a notification having 10 more items in the category of drugs, including intraocular lenses, including bone cements, including prosthetic replacements, so on. And this happened why? There was a need at that time. Everybody knows about the case of Johnson & Johnson's, that is falsy hip joint, you know, cases where the company has to pay a lot of compensation to all the poor patients who suffered a lot due to that faulty, you know, hip joints. Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, time to time, in consultation with the Drug Consultative Committee, where all the state drug controller meet and, you know, discuss what notification ought to be brought out and what is to be amended in the MDR Act or in the Drug and Cosmetic Act. And finally, in consultation with the Drug Technical Advisory Board, brings different notifications from time to time so that the regulations are well in place. And since January 2018, I can see there are about 14 to 15 notifications in the category of medical devices only, which the Government of India has brought in consultation with Drug Technical Advisory Board. Some of the notification I can share here. In June 2018, the Government of India, because the quality was a big issue for, you know, formulations, whether it is a drug or it is a capsule or a dosage form, everything is well specified in Indian Pharmacopoeia, in British Pharmacopoeia, and in United States Pharmacopoeia, and so on. And all parameters for quality control, for analysis of all these formulations are well defined in the concerned pharmacopoeias. But for medical devices, it is a big challenge, particularly related to the quality issues. So Government of India notified 5 labs in June 2018 as central medical devicing testing laboratories. That includes National Institute of Biological Noida, CDTL Chennai, CDL Kolkata, RDTL Guwahati, and CDTL Mumbai. So all these categories of all these, you know, laboratories were notified for different categories of medical devices to be tested from quality point of issue. Later on, once you know these laboratories were notified, there was a need to notify the government analyst who should be the medical device testing officers for, you know, these medical devices. So under Section 20 of MDR, you know, rules, on July 2018, Government of India notified the various government analysts as the medical device testing officers for different categories of medical devices. So this was first the labs, then the government analyst. Then there was a need. In December 18, there was a big issue, and then it was discussed in the Drug Consultative Committee meeting also, and finally with the DTAB approval, Government of India notified nebulizers, BP monitoring devices, digital thermometers, glucometers, all under the definition of medical devices and drug. And these devices were notified as drug with effect from 1st January 2020. But now again, the date has been extended. It will be it is extended up to the 1st January 2021. Later on, again, in February 2019, there was a need, and the Government of India again notified the following medical devices, you know, as the drug items like CT scan equipments, MRI equipments, PET equipments, dialysis machines, with effect from 1st April 2020. But again, the date has been extended up to 27th December 2019. Then, again in October 2019, Government of India notified the ultrasound equipments notified as drug item, and whether they are meant for external use or meant for internal use, and they will be the drug item with effect from 1st of November 2020. Remember, drug item means any of the item which is used for the treatment, mitigation of the disease in human body or animals, as per the Section 3B of the Drug and Cosmetic Act, they are defined as the drug items. Again, Government of India decided to bring Medical Devices Amendment Rule 2020. And again, on 11 February 2020, Government of India notified the Medical Devices Amendment Rules 2020, means all devices, including an instrument, any apparatus, any implants, any material or any other article, either used alone or in combination, to be used in animals or in human body, will be covered under the definition of drug. Now, during this COVID time, we are facing a lot of challenge, particularly, you know, using these, you know, PPE kits, using the sanitizers, using the mask. So there was no other option for the Government of India. Government of India notified the mask and the hand sanitizers under the category of the Essential Commodities Act. They covered under the Essential Commodities Act. But PPE kit is still a big challenge among the Government of India, because you see these personal protective equipments, which are now widely used nowadays by all the hospitals all over the country, all over the worldwide, but they are not regulated as on date. So a big issue related to the, you know, PPE kit used to manufacture the PPE kits, which plays a very important role, is a big challenge, and Government of India is still working on that, how to regulate these PPE kits. Government of India also notified 8 laboratories for testing the material for the use for the manufacture of PPE kits, and they have requested the all the PPE kits manufacturers to register on the Government of India portal, that is cdscomdonline.gov.in. So they have requested that each and everyone who is manufacturing these PPE kits at least register on the government portal, so that finally the inspection is to be carried out and they are properly well placed, having the proper license under the QMS scheme, that is quality management system. Now question comes. Now the issue comes. Sorry, some phones are coming in between. Our Honorable Prime Minister has already told, our country is the, you know, pharmacy of the world. on one side, our country is exporting formulations, or almost 60% of the formulations from our country to the other countries. But this is not on the side of the medical devices. In case of medical devices, we are mainly dependent on the import of the product. So whether it is an import or an export, we have to make our country very strong, particularly in reference to the production, in manufacturing of all the medical devices within our country. One of the example is APIs industry. Now, during this COVID time, our country was importing maximum of the pharmaceuticals and API from China. But since this COVID situations, we are facing a lot of problems, particularly in getting these APIs. So our Honorable Prime Minister well said that vocal for local, let us become Atmanirbhar, let us become self-dependent. So let us make our medical devices industry so much strong, we should not be dependent on other countries. And whenever any pandemic or any epidemic or any such situation comes, we should be well, sufficient, strong. We should be well strong so as to meet each and every requirement for healthcare system. My appeal to all, manufacturers, particularly in the field of medical devices, let us make our system very strong. Let us not dependent on the other countries, and let us see the quality issues are well in place, and whatever the medical devices are being used in our country, they should be for the benefit of the patients. I will conclude that this is a tough time. Drug Control Department, Regulatory Department, Indian Council of Medical Research, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Department of Pharmaceuticals, National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, Indian Council of Medical Research, all are working together along with the pharma industry, like Indian Medical IDMA, like BDMA, and like medical devices industry. Let us join our hands together to fight this COVID, and definitely we'll come out. And I wish each and everyone to stay safe and take care of yourself and follow the guidelines from the Government of India, from the ministry coming from time to time, by maintaining the social distance, by maintaining the hygiene, by increasing the immunity, by maintaining the lifestyle, by maintaining the diet control, by maintaining self-discipline, and by helping everyone. Thank you very much.